one of the biggest challenges for anybody in this, you know, in coaching or in playing, is that you want it to happen tomorrow, you know. And I think anything having is worth cultivating and growing, and we're going to figure each other out. And we've got to be smart about not overdoing it. You know, as I watch tape and film from last year of our team, you know, there were a lot of plays that were made instinctually out of kind of a knowledge of each other that we're going to have to build and grow. And it takes some time. But everybody seems to be on board, excited, and ready to roll with trying to make it as good as it can be, as quickly as it can be. You know, I was just telling Abby and Scal when I was doing a television interview, in a lot of ways, I feel like I took a new job. Because, you know, as a coach, you're always thinking about kind of, okay, what did we need to get better from last year? How do we need to improve? And, you know, I'm thinking about some of the, you know, looking at our stats and talking about our team about how we want to improve. Well, you know, 10 of the guys are going to be looking at me like I wasn't here last year. And I think that there's a reality to, we have to be able to focus on the details. We have to be able to focus on what we do best. We know what everybody does best individually, how that complements each other, and how we can bring that out sooner rather than later is the task at hand. So, you know, I said this to Gary Washburn the other day, like, my boss at Butler, Todd Licklider, used to quote Lincoln when he said, "I apologize for the length of this letter. I didn't have time to write a short one." We've tried to spend the last month as a staff honed in on how to make it as simple as possible. Like, how can we make this transition as seamless for everybody as possible? And, you know, we're looking forward to really getting to work as a full team tomorrow.